the Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, and evolve. Sister, spiritual inspiration shared through the arts. Sister, spiritual inspiration shared through Ayana. When can you listen to the Sister Speak Show? At 7 p.m. Central. Tune in on the go or at your residential. Spreaker, YouTube, Alexa, or SoundCloud. Interviewing special guests that have been blessed and will bless us. Through spoken word and awareness, knowledge is wealth. If you gain it, share this. In the streets, in the burbs, anywhere that we can be heard. It's about that time to elevate your mind. Through the beat, Sister Speak. Come and eat a spiritual treat. It's about that time to stimulate your mind. Feel the beat, Sister Speak. Come and eat a spiritual treat.
Brothers and sisters, welcome to the tour on the Sister Speak Show. I am your host, Ayana. Not only am I the host, I am the host, creator, and producer of the Sister Speak Show. Kingdom Child Recordings is executive producer of the Sister Speak Show. My brothers and sisters, oh, it's going all the way up this evening because anything going down is crashing. It's going all the way up this evening, my brothers and sisters. We have a live special guest interview, my brothers and sisters, and this is a Dallas interview, to be exact with you. But let me explain to you, to all of my first-time listeners, what the Sister Speak Show is about. We are a six-segment podcast, my brothers and sisters. We are syndicated on Amazon Alexa. We are here to serve you, my brothers and sisters. Now, what you will be able to do when you listen to the Sister Speak Show is you will be able to catch special guest interviews, live performances, in-studio interviews, and live on-location reports, okay? The special guests who will be on the Sister Speak Show are dynamic, and they are impacting the communities with their passions. The Sister Speak Show is a talk show that will keep your mind and your soul informed, energized, and encouraged. We are a cultural renaissance platform that influences a climate that is conducive to who you are and who you should be. No reckless entertainment, just responsible listening nourishment. We don't go dumb. We go wisdom on the Sister Speak Show, my brothers and sisters, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, and evolve, my brothers and sisters. So guess what? We've got a jam-packed show for you this evening. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
Brothers and sisters, listen live this Saturday to the tour on the Sister Speak Show. The tour where we are dedicated towards covering every aspect of the music industry. Dallas, stand up. My special guest will be recording artist Clue. I'm so excited about this interview. We're going to talk about his new single, Riding High, and everything else that he has going on in the music industry. If you don't have a clue, you better get one on the Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. This week on the Sister Speak Show, we've got you covered starting at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time on Tuesday with Coming to the Stage, Wednesday, The Search Effort, Thursday on the tour, my special guest, Charles Thomas, saxophonist for the City and Soul Creatures, Friday, Get Ready to Laugh with the Laugh Line, Saturday, recording artist, Dallas, Stand Up, Clue will be my special guest on the tour, and then Sunday on the platform, my special guest, author, creative writer, and speaker, Damon Alvarez, on the Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. Brothers and sisters, we want you to listen live and on demand to the Sister Speak Show. There are six segments dedicated to serving you, my brothers and sisters. We have the platform, coming to the stage, the culture climate, the laugh line, the tour, and the search effort. Oh, the Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, and evolve. The search effort, local, national, international attention to those who have gone missing in our communities. Cold cases in our communities. Stories from survivors. Special guest interviews. We want you to be on the Sister Speak Show. Are you a survivor of a stalking, a kidnapping? Do you have a missing loved one? Contact the Sister Speak Show at SGT, PGW, or at SisterGoodThing.com. Airing January 2018, Wednesday, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time.
My brothers and my sisters, welcome back to the Tour on the Sister Speak Show. So that's right, Dallas, stand up. My special guest will be recording artist Clue. If you don't have a clue, you better get one. Not only about him, but about the Sister Speak Show. I'm so excited to interview this brother. You know, I'm in Dallas. He's in Dallas. So this is like a hometown connection here. So excited about networking and, you know, just being able to vibe out with all of these creative artists locally, nationally, and internationally, my brothers and sisters. So you did hear it right. We are a syndicated podcast on Amazon Alexa, and I'm very grateful about that. So brothers and sisters, tonight we have something very special for you. You know, we have Clue's single. Okay, I'm so excited about it. Riding High, my brothers and sisters. You are going to be able to listen to it live this evening. Yes, we're going to play it for you on the Sister Speak Show. Why wouldn't we? So anyway, to all of his supporters, I want to send a shout out to you. What's going on? You know, I want to say hello to all of my listeners. And also, once again, welcome to all of my first-time listeners. So my brothers and sisters, let me explain something to you about the tour and how I get up on the tour. Look, the tour is dedicated towards every aspect of the music industry. We try to cover it all, from musicians to sound engineers. You know, we don't want to skip a beat when it comes to the industry. And one thing about me is I like music, but I like good music. I like music that makes sense. I like, you know, of course I like a good beat, but I'm not for music that doesn't have longevity. You know, I believe that if you're going to use your creativity, that you should also include the word longevity in your rhymes. And what I mean by this, excuse me, when you write your rhymes, you got to be able to put out hits. You know, you got to be a heavy hitter. Whether, you know, and I really like to work with independent artists, but, you know, if you're going to create, it's got to be something that's just really going to, you know, move for years. You know, I want to be able to play it no matter what year it is, and be like, this is a classic. You know what I'm saying? No matter what time of the year it is, it's all about great music. It's all about, do you have the ability to really be behind the microphone? You know what I'm saying? Like, are you supposed to really be rapping? You know, we really get down to it. I keep it 100 on this show. Like, if you aren't supposed to be rapping, look. Because I believe that, like I said, and I will always say on my show, that you need, look, some people need to have a rap license. You need to pull it out. Don't just tell me to go listen to your mixtape. And you know that you just putting out a mixtape just to be putting out a mixtape. Goodness, by my mixtape. Okay, look, I'm all about supporting my brothers and sisters and all of that. But what I'm saying is this. If you want me to listen to your music, do you have a license to rap? Because I hear some songs and I'm just like, what's up? What's going on? Right? But then on the other hand, I hear so many dope music that it's just like, oh my gosh. You know, and the thing about it is when you're an independent artist, you know, and all jokes aside, I do respect the craft. But when you are an independent artist, you know, the grind is real serious and you need to have a team that's really backing you. So that's what I like about Clue and what he has going on. And I really like the single. You know, I've played it about six times and I nod my head every single time. So we're going to get into it when he calls in. But look, why don't we go ahead and get this started? Brothers and sisters, you know, let's just do it. Brothers and sisters, this is Riding High, Clue.
Right, creeping slow, real flow, clean, candy bright, seize like a dream. top beam. Pose it up and let them flop the scene. Parking lot is where I reign as king. And if you're from the side, then you know what I mean. The dozer's up, so they gon' pop the team. The chain glistening, clean as crystal cream. Jam all the way through to the CD stop. Release date next year, when you see me cop? Press button, fold up and remove my top. With my face on swole and my trunk on knock. It's that summer time, ride high. Waving while I'm riding by. Sitting high like I'm trying to fly. Swinging hard like I'm trying to die.
Brothers and sisters, that was Riding High with recording artist Clue. My brothers and sisters, you know what? I just want to give them a round of applause because I feel like that single was absolutely dope. Love the beat. Love the song. Love the support. That's right, Dallas. Stand up. That's what's up. That's what's up, brothers and sisters. You are listening live to the tour on the Sister Speak Show, my brothers and sisters. My special guest will be calling in. We're going to vibe out with him. He has another obligation, you know, because, you know, when you're booked, you're booked. And when you're in demand, you're in demand. So I just appreciate the fact that he's stopping by the Sister Speak Show, you know, on his way to where he has to go. That's why we call this the tour, my brothers and my sisters. I got a couple songs that I'm going to be playing for you all a little bit later on. You know, just a couple, you know, hits that classics. You know, I think two of them are classics to be exact. And, you know, we're just going to vibe out and we're going to close the show on out. And, you know, we're going to move forward because, you know, the Sister Speak Show is Sunday through Sunday. And so you're able to listen to this show live and on demand. And so the beautiful thing I like about the Sister Speak Show and what it has to offer for you is that we are the flavor in your ear. We are here for your listening palate. Podcasts are very, very popular and, you know, they're dropping every second. But what's different about this podcast is that it's the Sister Speak Show. That's it. Spiritual inspiration shared through the arts, spiritual inspiration shared through Ayana. The main focus of the Sister Speak Show is encouragement. We believe in upliftment, my brothers and sisters. We don't believe in hating. We do believe in rebuking. We do believe in chastisement. We do believe in correction. But we also believe in, you know, providing wisdom and also providing listening nourishment for my brothers and my sisters, you know. We don't take any mess. It's all about the hues, hearing unique, exceptional stories about my brothers and my sisters. So that's why so far there are 6 segments for the Sister Speak Show. And the tour is so important because so many of my brothers and sisters, excuse me, are recording artists are attached to the music industry in some way or shape or form. And even if you are not attached to the music industry, you are if you like to listen to music, whatever genre it is, you know. And so we don't have any discriminations, if you will, when it comes to the genres that we, you know, would interview on this show. What I do not do is I don't do heavy metal, okay? I don't do rock and roll, okay? And what I mean by that is I don't do none of that death stuff. I don't do death. I'm all about life. If you are about death, then this isn't the show for you, because it is about breathing and living, okay? I want to tap into positive spirits, not wicked spirits, okay, my brothers and sisters? So understand that about the Sister Speak Show. Isn't that beat funky that you hear? Yes, that intro was created by the executive producer of the Sister Speak Show, Derek Ben Israel of Kingdom Child Recordings. Shout out to you, my husband. I appreciate all of your support with the Sister Speak Show. Brothers and sisters, that is what it's about. What does your support look like? Do you have any brothers and sisters that are in the music industry, you know, independent, on the grind? Are you supporting them? Are you retweeting? Are you reposting? Are you showing up at the shows? Are you buying their music? Like, what are you doing? Are you just waiting for them to pop so you can get in? I'm going to tell you something about your plans and how God causes the plans of man to take no effect. Look, if you are not supporting somebody from beginning, middle to end, do not expect to reap the benefits of what they receive. Okay? That's a word to you today. It can't be, what's up, my cousin? What's up, my sister? What's up, my brother? Nah, 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 nah. Is your support genuine? Are you going hard in the paint with them? Because let me tell you, in this industry, especially, okay, you need support, but you need like-minded support. And if you have not yet tapped into your passions, then I can understand why you may sometimes feel a little salty. But look, you don't have to feel salty. What you need to do is tap into your passions so you can pursue your purpose, so you can understand what the grind is for somebody who's an independent artist. It takes a lot, I'm quite sure, for Clue to do what he has to do. You know, booking shows and having a team, trusting your team, and all the what comes in with that, that's real. You know, being able to, you know, well, for me personally, I would not have anybody handling my money. What you won't be doing is securing my bag for me, okay? I know how to count. I know how to add. I know how to subtract. I know how to multiply. I know how to divide. I know how to do percentages. So we're going to cut that middleman out, because what you're not going to do is rob old folks and make a dash, okay? That's what you're not gonna do. So, you know, and if I, you know, and when I watch Unsung, you know, particularly just Unsung, not Unsung Hollywood, you know, you just see so many stories of people talking about how they ran off with the money, how one day they just looked up and everything was all gone. You know, in Saudi Arabia, if you steal, you get your hands cut off. You get your fingers cut off, too. I'm telling you, when I was living in the Bay, I went to a gas station one time, and I went to get my change, and I had to pull my hand back. Ain't trying to be shady, just got to be real. I pulled my hand back because the teller, if you will, the store guy, the cashier, he was missing three fingers. Kind of threw me off. I was like, okay, what's up? This is really West Side. For, no, that's not West Side. That's just peace. Anyway, so, you know, he didn't have his digits. And I was like, okay, I'm bold. I'm like, what happened? And he said, in my country, if you steal, they cut your fingers off. I'm like, whoa. And I'm like, so did you do it three times? You know what I'm saying? Like, no, that was just a punishment. So, you know, don't think just because in this country that you don't get your hands cut off, that you can't get your hands cut off. because God is able. And I just want to just share that with you guys. When it comes to your whole team, make sure that you understand that there are some people that you just don't need. And there are some people that you do need. And you also have to be willing for long nights and early mornings. The grind is real. And sometimes that train only, it only moves when you move. You know what I'm saying? So it's very important to understand that when it comes to being an independent artist, that number one, I think you're able to protect your craft better. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're able to just understand why you do what you do. You really don't want anybody watering down your projects. You don't want anybody watering down your whole purpose and passion. You know what I mean? Oh gosh, it's so real. And you don't want anybody taking away your sound. And so that way, like, if you're multi-talented, if you know how to produce and if you know how to, you know, not only produce, but mix and master and market and do all of those things, you're cutting out a lot of the money that you would have to pay out in the first place. I'm serious about that. GarageBand is making people millionaires. You better understand that. GarageBand is fattening the pockets of several producers, okay? And I'm telling you, there are so many dope producers out here that don't get the recognition that they should. I mean, putting out some dope beats, right? Just able to, you know, meet with the artist, understand the artist's vibe, and just hit that keyboard and that whole soundboard and come up with the dopest beats ever, my brothers and sisters. That's what I love about music. Being able to create a rhythm that has people moving and grooving and just like, yes, that's my song. That's my jam. You know, and I'm talking about really positive music. You know what I'm saying? I'm all for music that has a solution to it. And I'm always for some good R&B, some good old school R&B. You know what I'm saying, my brothers and sisters? You know, I was just thinking about a song the other day that it came out in the summertime. Don't quote me on this, but you know, this one right here would get the party moving and grooving. So we're just going to play a little bit of it. My guest might call in while the song is playing. We'll stop the song and, you know, get right into that vibe. But do y'all remember this song? Q-Tip Violator, Vibrant Thing.
Check it out now. No doubt, yo. Special girl, real good girl. Biggest thing in my itty bitty world. Call her up and she made me feel right. Wish the bliss could never take flight. Sitting back with this mic in my hand. Spitting hot shit, trying to see green. Imprinted on my mind every minute. Make my plans and you always in it, yo. Such a vibrant thing. And even though we both fly, give each other space and not the evil eye. Acting like grown-ups, don't even try to hide, cause the spot blown up. Girlfriend telling you she wanna see. I say I don't know, but you say gladly. And when we both do it, we go on and on and on and on and on and sweeter than Ben and Jerry. Can't rhyme, but well, you know I guess mine. Sitting around in my abstract car. This abstract thing going abstract far. Yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing.
Look at, check it, look at,
check it,
look at,
yeah,
check it, look at,
yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing.
Look at, yeah,
check it,
look at, yeah,
check it,
look at,
yeah, check it,
look at, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Such a vibrant thing. Getting back to my MC status. All the willy that I kick make the other maddest. Move it to your town and situation. Shorty thought she subtle, but she really was blatant with you. Shook a thing and violated. Now these wolf-like thoughts are formulated. I'm saying, though, is there some heart up in here? Am I still in bag?
Well,
yeah. Plus we can hold the convo or go to the movie. always my crib, whatever, yo. Just wanna see you by my side. We on 95, know the stash is in the ride. Rapping again for real. You would find me in the cypher if I didn't cop a deal. Rap slate like big weight. You buy, I sell, we split big cake. Cause move your little thing. Move around and shake a little thing. Yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing.
Brothers and sisters, that was Q-Tip, Vibrant Thing. I'm telling you, that beat right there, right? Okay? Dancing nonstop, that's good workout music. I'm telling you, that's what I'm talking about. Like, taking the time out to make it to where I can be moving and grooving from beginning, middle, and end of the song. I got another throwback for you, brothers and sisters. This was a duo called Ill and Out Scratch. This is I'll Take Her featuring Brian McKnight.
Looked up and down, said, I'll take her.
Don't
Brothers and sisters, that was Ill and Out Scratch featuring Brian McKnight. See, that's the one thing I do like about recording songs like that, is the fact that you get somebody who knows how to hit those R&B notes, and then you got two brothers, or even one brother or sister, whoever, you know, with the mad rhyme skills. Oh, and put together a classic like that. Always you can bump that, and you just, you know, ease on back in your ride and look, do what you do. That's what it's about. You know, what type of music are you putting out that I can ride to? No matter what the season is, like, what are you like? Can you put out dope music for every season for me? Because summertime, I'm pulling back the moonroof, sunroof. I'm letting the windows down. I'm either in the Beamer or the Benz, and I'm out of here and I'm doing what I do. What I want to know is, how are you going to help my day go along with your rhymes? You know what I'm saying? When it comes to music, I got one for you, though. I have another one for you, my brothers and sisters, that I'm going to play. When it comes to music, there's just some songs that just are classic. And here's one right now. This is Heavy D featuring The Boys. Somebody for me. Don't you want to have somebody for you? Yeah. Ain't nothing like it. The late Heavy D and Trouble T. Roy. Come on. That's right. You are listening to The Tour. We are live. I am your host, Ayana. You are listening to The Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, and evolve. My special guest is supposed to be calling in. We're going to rock out till he calls in. We're going to vibe out. Come on. Hope your evening is going well. My evening is going well. Let's get it. Let's go. Nothing. It seems as if every time I find the right girl, she turns out to be the big wrong girl. Tell me, y'all, the mother's madness. Stop. I want somebody to love me for me. Not because I'm MC FBD. I'm looking for a love that's as solid as a rock. Brothers and sisters calling in live to the Sister Speak Show on The Tour. My special guest, Clue. Let's give him a round of applause, my brothers and sisters. How are you doing?
I
ain't mad at you. I knew you was gonna call and look. That's why we have the show already rolling on and popping. Cause you look, I knew you was gonna call in, so I wasn't even worried about it. You a booked brother. You're busy in things, so I understand these things.
I appreciate it, man. Thank you for understanding.
Of course, it's all good. I just thank you for even, you know, being willing to stop by the Sister Speak Show and be on a tour and just bless us with who you are and what you got going on. Dallas, I want you to stand up. You know, I'm really excited about recording artist Clue calling in. You are listening live to the Sister Speak Show. So let's go ahead and let's get it and let's go. Let's just start out. I just played your single in the beginning of the show. I love it. I love Riding High. It's dope. The beat is dope. The lyrics are dope. It's absolute fire. I've played it about, this is my seventh time playing it, so shout out to you.
Okay.
You know, I just wanted to say that.
I definitely appreciate that, man. And I made that song for you. I had you in mind when I was putting that down, you know?
I appreciate that. That's what I'm talking about. So let's go ahead and get started. When did you know that you were supposed to be behind the mic?
Man, I have a rather musically inclined family.
Mm-hmm.
And music is something that we're all pretty rooted in. Like, everybody can come together over a good song, always. And since a young age, I saw that I was talented in writing and all of those things. And I was, you know, writing stuff in my book, doing little battle raps and stuff in, like, middle school, early.
Mm.
And, would do stuff, and it was fun. It was just something to do. But I lived a little more life, and I got a few more experiences, and I realized that was something that I was really passionate about. So I've only been recording for, I'll say, 3 years now. And in that amount of time, I feel like I've accomplished a lot of goals within myself, and I got a lot more to come.
That's what I'm talking about. But you know what? The thing about it is when you rhyme and when you take the time out to really do it, it shows. And so it shows in your music. Your music sounds clean. You understand what I'm saying to you? It doesn't sound like something that you just, hey, said, you know what? Let me go ahead and put something out real quick. It really sounds like you took the time or you've been taking the time. It doesn't say, you know, 3 years. It sounds pretty great to me. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome so much. So you were talking about, you know, you were doing battle raps and everything like that. So I just want, you know, the listening audience to kind of, you know, journey just a, you know, a little bit in the beginning with you and what that experience was like. Because, you know, when it comes to battle rapping, look, you got to be ready.
Yeah, you definitely got to be ready. And I mean, like, it was fun because when I was coming up, you know, some stuff was written and it was understood, but for the most part, we were actually freestyling. We were enjoying the art of what it was.
Yeah.
So it's a, you know, it's nostalgic. It holds a dear place in my heart. And I never like battle rap past anything like high school.
Right.
But you know, it was fun to do. It was a good workout.
I totally get it. And so then, do you find writing to be therapeutic for you?
Always, because you can say everything. You can talk to yourself. You can talk for someone else. You can write things that have happened.
Mm-hmm.
You can write things that you want to happen. Like, you can will, through writing, you can will things into existence.
Mm-hmm.
So, writing is a therapy in so many ways beyond the comfort and the solitude in it, you get a stimulation as well, because you got to be able to do this thing, you know?
Totally. And so then, have you ever been able to really just save somebody else's life by you writing? What I mean by that is, you know, for me, like, instead of me choking somebody out or, you know, taking it to a different level, I just can, you know, write it down on a piece of paper and get it out that way. I have written several letters and never mailed them.
Word.
You feel me? I've gone ham. Hard, like ruthless records in it, like seriously, like seriously though, because you know, just if you leave it on the inside, it can be worse for people and even for yourself. So I have definitely written several letters that I never mailed. You know what I'm saying?
I completely understand that. Like I got a lot of songs that'll never come out.
Go ahead. No, I was just saying, can you hear me?
Oh yeah, I got you. I was saying that I have plenty of songs that'll never come out. So I completely understand you in that. You gotta just get it out sometime.
You do. And so then, like, who have been some of your influences, you know, as far as music is concerned?
Man, like, I was just blessed and fortunate enough to be influenced by so many different artists. Like, everything from before I started rapping, I heard Rick James and J. Cole. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it was a pretty good range. Like, it's not just limited to the older people that I grew up on, because I wasn't making music earlier then. It was just things that I was listening to and what influenced me to want to rap again. So to give some names, definitely Outkast, definitely Jay-Z, Biggie, Snoop, Crit, Kendrick, J. Cole, Wale, Smino, G, Earth Gang, Mac Miller, Tyler the Creator, Kanye West, Lil Wayne, Drake, Bankroll Fresh, Gucci, everybody, like, it's just so, 2 Chainz,
for sure,
Action Bronson, ODB is my man, like, it's just so many influences that I grew up with and that I just, that made me love music, made me love rap, and all of that goes into what I do, I feel.
For sure. And so, you know, one thing that I feel like is if you're going to be in the rap game, it should be because, you know, you're creative. You know, you got some people who are out there and they just don't, they don't make the cut, Clue. They just don't make the cut. They don't.
Thanks for saying that.
They don't. That, look, they need a rap license. I've said this before. If you need a license to get married and a license to fish and a license to hunt, at this point in the hip-hop, we've got to have some brothers and sisters. Look, you need a rap license. Are you authorized? Are you authorized to be behind the mic? You know what I'm saying?
Are you authorized to be behind the mic? You know, I love it. Are you authorized to be behind the mic? Yeah, you... we should standardize this. We'll talk off air about how to, you know, go public with this movement, but I support this.
I do
rap
too.
2018.
Real talk though, because you know, like look, Mac, look, mixtapes come out all the time. You know, you can catch anybody talking about, you know, I'm a rapper and, you know, I try to give a fair shot. You know, I listen and then it's like, they only have a permit. You know what I'm saying? They need to take some courses because it's just like sometimes people are trying to rap just because they need that game so they can get a female. You know what I'm saying? I just have an issue. You know what I'm saying? Because I just like, you know, a lot of times we know, you know, some people rap because they need it to help their swag. You feel me?
Right.
And that's where I have an issue because it's just like, if you're rapping just to get the females or you're rapping just to get the dudes, then gosh, you're really exposing the fact that, you know what I mean? Your game is weak. You feel me? I don't
right. Even without this, you know, Lord forbid I suffer a tragic car accident and my vocals don't work tomorrow, I can still get the job done.
Right. Right. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it's about. And definitely, you know, being able to just put your stamp in Dallas, which that's what I believe you are doing. So let's just talk about the music industry in Dallas so we can let everybody know, because this is a syndicated podcast. This is an international show. So we have people that have been listening from the Netherlands, Australia, Jamaica, Mexico. So, you know, we really are able to, we're reaching India as well as Canada. So, you know, let's get it. Let's go. So what is the music scene like in Dallas?
Man, Dallas is seeing that I'm not from Dallas.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just looking at it, you know, like from the perspective of this is how I see people handle business in Dallas. Like Dallas is two-sided. It's like the kind of, I guess you would call it trap or maybe dance music, all of that's like one side.
Mm-hmm.
Then it's just like the backpackers on the other side. Mm. Like everybody, the other side, everybody over there kind of has a thing that's kind of like, okay, so that's your thing. And that's where they're riding at. And it's real clicky.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody just hangs around those people.
Mm.
And that's just kind of how it looks and how it goes. But the few people that I'm seeing, like, making good moves and doing good things or staying true to themselves on whichever side of the spectrum that they're on, and they are succeeding. And that's all I want to do, is stay true to myself so I could just maintain it, get my own. And the scene is, it's nice. It's receptive. It's your product is quality. And I feel that everybody that I've gained contact with and all my fans and Dallas, and not only Dallas, but all over the place in Mississippi, Arkansas, Texas, Georgia, Florida, everywhere. I got people all over the bubble that like what I'm doing. So I think that just comes from, you know, keeping it cool wherever you at. But Dallas is definitely a great scene.
I'm glad for you, you know, and I'm so glad that not only in Texas are you getting the love, but in the rest of the states. And that's what the Sister Speak show is about. Now, look, everybody's going to hear about Clue, and you're going to get a clue about Clue, because if they come through the Sister Speak show, you can trust me that this is a legit move. So, brothers and sisters, I need you to make sure that you support what he has going on. To all of my brothers and sisters who are heavy into hip hop, who are heavy into good music, good rap music, clean mixing and mastering, and good lyrics, and lyrics that make sense, you know what I'm saying, and tell a good story, then you need to check this brother out. And I can tell that Outkast is one of your influences, because I love Outkast. One of my favorite songs is the Art of Storytelling. Hands down. Oh my gosh. You know, look, there's just some songs that for me, I just have to remember. I just got to memorize all the lyrics. So, you know, number one, I don't get caught slipping like I don't know what, you know, what the song is. But also, but they are just so, you know, just the story. If you can tell a story, no matter what it is, I don't care, even if it's grimy, because if that is what you have experienced, then hands down, other people have experienced it too. And we can't, you know, I've learned not to be judgmental when I'm hearing something that may just not be anything I've ever experienced per se, because it's still a story. It still makes for great music, because this person is actually healing while talking about it. You know what I'm saying? So whether it's grimy or it's sensual, you know what I'm saying? It's just about, you know, being able to grasp your audience. And I think that's what you did, especially with Riding High. I really like that.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And while we're on the topic of storytelling, everybody listening, if you want to hear a great story, just type it in on YouTube, Lil Boy Black, LilBoyBlack, by Clue, CLEW, great story. That's all I tell you. If you do it, congratulations. You will.
You better understand what he just said to you. So, you know, one thing I want to talk about is the music industry is the men versus women, and not in a competition, but just as who do you feel has it easier in this industry, and who do you feel has to do more in order to make themselves known in the industry?
Well, I mean, at this point, I feel like it's really just at a point where anybody can make it, because the biggest success of last year was Cardi B.
Mm-hmm.
And she was, I mean, who? She had an outstanding year.
Yes, she did.
You know, like, and she's clearly a female. And that's not to say that other male artists weren't having those same types of accomplishments, but she was doing it and doing it well, you know? So anybody can make it at this point. I just feel like if you want it, go and grab it.
Wow. And, you know, but the thing about it is, do you think reality TV is a way for artists to get on, or do you think that's like, you know, one in a million?
Popularity can breed anything. Boom Gang started rapping after he got a million followers on Instagram. Like, popularity can breed anything. If, as long as you can fund it, you can do it. And if that's how you have to get to it, that's how a lot of people get to it. Like, now, it's weird because, like, you don't have to sell drugs anymore. You can just get a bunch of followers. And, like, people will pay you because you have a ton of followers.
They sure will. I mean, the game is real. And you know what I do like about, you know, the whole point of being an independent artist is you get to take more money home for your family. I think it is a disgrace that so many of our brothers and sisters go through the music industry and they just get done so dirty when it comes to payment, you know what I mean? Because by the time the money trickles down to them, you know, a lot of people be like, oh, they balling. But nah, man, they really are getting the short end of the stick, if you will. So you're an independent artist, correct?
Yes,
So can you share with the listening audience the joys, the pros, or even the cons of being an independent artist? Because I know there are going to be several people listening that want to go the route that you're going, but they may not have that wisdom, and they may not know, or may have, you know, somewhat of a fear of approaching somebody to ask for it. So do you mind sharing the wisdom that you've gained so far as an independent artist?
Okay. I'll tell you there's some honest truths. Number one rule, nobody cares. Work harder. Nobody cares. Like, everything can go wrong. So what? Did you do it or not? You have to execute. That was something that I was talking to myself about forever. And then when I started doing things, things started happening. Nobody cares. Nobody cares. Nobody's going to help you. You got to get it.
I think that's the truth. and I came to that realization probably last year. So I understand what you're saying. And so then how did you pick yourself up when you were discouraged? What were some of the things that happened for you when you, you know, kind of were feeling a little low, when you might have been almost on E?
Well, I have a great support system, a great team.
That's
everybody that works with me and around me is fantastic, and we see it. This is something that we're building for ourselves, so we're all equally excited and invested.
Mm-hmm.
I know they're listening. What up to y'all?
Shout out to your team. Yeah, I'm so excited that you have that support system, and that is what it's about. You know, I always try to encourage my brothers and sisters to be supporters. You never know when it's going to be your turn to become independent, to pursue your passion, to venture off into the unknown and become absolutely dynamic at what you do. You just never know. And so a lot of times people are being tested on, you know, their character. And I think the good thing about it is that when you support someone genuinely, you know, that comes back your way. But it also stores up, you know, the opportunity for other people to support what you do. You know what I'm saying? Support is just so vital. And sometimes our brothers and sisters can just be haters. We just got to be honest. I mean, just smooth, funky haters. You know what I'm saying? And so the one thing that I like I say, I just want to encourage my brothers and sisters to always support, especially when you hear brothers like Clue and other brothers and sisters out there doing what they do. So I'm going to switch this up a little bit. You know, one thing I don't do is I don't do messy interviews. And that's what I like to have. I like to have a respectful, positive interview. So you'll want to come back on the Sister Speak show, you know, because I don't ever want to get anybody caught up on anything. So I'm just going to make a general statement or a general question. And, you know, we'll see how it goes when it comes to love in hip hop. And I'm not talking about the reality show. I'm actually talking about love and hip hop. How do you handle, and oh, I hope I'm asking this without causing any issues. How do you handle, you know, working and then also trying to, if you, you know, maintain a relationship, you know, or what is some of the advice that you might give for someone who is trying to do that? You know, I don't want to get anybody in trouble.
You put effort into anything you want.
Yes. And so when it comes to groupies, I always have to ask this because I'm absolutely fascinated by the thirstiness of groupies. I mean, just the actual dehydration that occurs with groupies. How do you handle that, or do you have to deal with that at all?
I don't have any groupies.
How do you deal with the fans?
The fans are just the fans. They understand our relationship. They appreciate me for what I do.
Mm-hmm.
And we live our lives.
Okay, because, you know, sometimes, you know, when you get on stage, sometimes that there is just a attraction that comes with being on stage. You know, a lot of times, you know, people are like, oh, my gosh, and they just, you know, they become attracted. And so then how do you stay professional? Because, you know, some people be like, meet me at the Amtrak station, you know, meet me at the bus station. Like, how do you deal with that?
No, this is not like a old sexy flexy show. I'm not trying to be a sex symbol out here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to, you know, I'm cool and I kick it, and that's how I hang out.
That's what's up.
And that's it.
I love it. I love it. See, I'm always trying to be careful because I never know. You know, I always want to make sure everybody keeps their DMs from getting lit up. And, you know, I don't want anybody getting any, you know, violent text messages or anything like that. You know, I'm just trying to understand, you know, what's going on. So I'm going to move past that. And I'm going to move all the way past that. So what's coming up next for Clue?
Man. So many things, man. So many things, and I'm almost superstitious about them. I kind of don't even want to speak on the things to come. I just want to tell you, keep watching. I promise it's about to get good.
And so, when you say keep watching, tell my listening audience how they can keep watching Clue.
Oh, I could be found on all social media platforms at GoClue, GoClew. My last album, Champagne Brunches, is available off all streaming platforms. Tidal, Apple Music, Spotify, iTunes, Google Music, and Champagne Brunches, again by Clue, C-L-E-W.
And how did you get that? I mean, tell everybody how you came up, how the name Clue came about.
Oh, Clue is that's just a mashup of my real name. My name is Christian Lewis.
Oh, all right. Yes. See, that was very smooth. I like that. That's a very nice name. That's a name
thank
that, you, yeah, that's a name that denotes, you know, run me my money. You understand what I'm saying to you? That's real smooth. I appreciate
game
it. Yeah, game recognized game all the time. So, you know, one thing I always like to ask everybody who comes on the tour is if you could put together a cipher with five artists, who would it be?
Five artists, cipher.
And it could be past or present artists. It doesn't matter. It's your flavor.
I'm going with my right now, guys. I'm going to say Doc and Venus from Earth Gang, Jid, Kendrick Lamar, and Currency.
Okay.
That'll be a fucking cipher.
Okay, and then if you could put together a tour of any group, anything, who would you would like to see in a tour?
Who would I like to see on a tour? Or who
yeah.
would I like to go on a tour with?
Well, we could ask that question second, but, you know, who would you like to, if you could put together a tour, and of course you could include yourself in that, but who would you like to see? You know, come together as a tour, coming to Dallas, coming to wherever.
I'll take that same group.
Okay.
Or just to see a tour.
Mm-hmm. And so who would
yeah,
you like? I'm sorry for cutting you off. And then who would you like to go on tour with?
Drake, Beyonce, and Bruno Mars.
Okay. You got to tell me why.
Like, everybody's going to be way hip to what Clue is after that.
Yes.
Everybody's going to be on that. And if I make it to where that can happen, mm-hmm. All right, cool.
Oh yeah. Well, you know, you keep doing what you do, and the one thing I know about God is he does things suddenly. A lot of times, you know, you'll be working, and sometimes, you know, you'll be like, okay, when is this going to happen? People are watching you, Clue. You better know that. So you better keep doing what you're doing, because sooner than later, you know, I'll be able to say, well, would you look at there? Look at Clue. There is Clue over there opening up for the BET Awards. Well, now look at that. Okay. There he is. Look, see, because I'm all with you, my brother. You know what I'm saying? So I just really see. Oh, did you hear Clue? He was on a feature with such and such and such and such. Oh, Clue? Oh, yeah, he got that feature with Kendrick Lamar. Did you hear it? You know what I'm saying? So that's why we put this out here. That's why we have this podcast, because, you know, as we talk, it happens. You understand what I'm saying to you? So everything you're saying, it could very well manifest. So I'm looking forward to see what you got going on. You know what I'm saying? But one thing I do want to ask you is give some wisdom. Would you please give some wisdom to the listening audience? Anything that you want to give them?
manage your time.
Mm-hmm.
Try your best to save your money.
Oh, goodness. Yes, that's what. And get your credit up. Credit is, everybody, credit is a footstool for us. That is leverage. It is all about how you do what you do. I'm just wanting, because so many, you know, so many people think that once their credit scores are low or whatever, that there's no come up. No, there are ways to raise that score. Once you raise your credit score, who can tell you no? Who can deny you? Now you're being able to fund certain things, and you know, you also have to have discipline and everything, but that credit score is serious in the paint. It's real serious.
Right on.
You know what
Absolutely.
I'm saying? It's very serious. So you have something going on this evening. What is it that you got going on?
That's a level 5 security clearance, and I didn't get the email back from your people about where you were, so I can't discuss that with you on
air. Ayana, move right along quickly. Okay, so now here we go. I ain't trying to get caught up with nothing this evening. But I do want to ask you this when it comes to women. What do you think is your preference? And I mean this in a disgusting way. I'm going to respect you as a man. But when it comes to a woman with natural hair versus, you know, other people's hair, you know, how do you feel about that? Do you prefer a woman to be natural, or do you prefer her to shine in somebody else's crown?
I'm definitely a team natural.
Okay, and why? Because, you know, some brothers be like, I don't care, but please share so other women will be encouraged to understand that it's okay.
Oh, it's because it's beautiful. It's beautiful. You grew it yourself, you know? Like, this is your hard work paid off, and in its true form, like, do that, be you.
Okay, and so then what about, you know, women, you know, getting the booty shots, the butt implants, the Brazilian lifts? What do you think about that? Because I know that our sisters are naturally curvy, you know, and so for me, I mean, even, you know, of course you run across a few that it's like, okay, maybe that, you know, puberty skipped over them. But besides that, how do, you know, you think, you know, it looks on a woman who decides to get, you know, cosmetic butt implants?
I mean, I don't prefer those, but, you know, if that's something that you want to do, that's what you want to do. And I'm an advocate for that. I mean, because it's about being fair. If you allow a thing, allow that thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm cool with people being themselves, you know. So if that's what you want to do, do that. I don't like it. So, but, it does, you know, that doesn't matter to me.
Mm-hmm. And so, it, you know, you basically are for a woman being natural, and you think that it looks better on a woman just to do her, correct?
Right.
Okay, I appreciate that. So anything else that you want to share with our listening audience on the Sister Speak Show? Do you want to spit a couple bars for us, or did you say no?
I consulted. And I was directed that we should be leaving soon. So
okay.
Next time I'm on the show, though, I promise I got you.
Okay, I appreciate that.
I got you.
Okay.
Hold me to that. Next time I'm on the show.
Okay, cool. Well, see, hopefully next time you're on the show, this will be a face-to-face interview, because we are doing some upgrades with the Sister Speak Show. But I do appreciate you for coming on the Sister Speak Show. I really do. I thank you for being on the tour. I support everything that you got going on. I'm going to play your single one more time before I get off this show. But thank you for calling, and I will send you a copy of the interview.
Thank you so much, man. And to everybody listening, thank y'all. Thank y'all so much for listening and putting up with me for a little while. And it can be found at GoClue, GoClew.
Definitely.
And the best is yours.
Yeah, and so did you have a good time on the Sister Speak Show?
I had a blast. Like, this was just such a cool conversation. Like, I'm anxious to get up and just speak freely with you guys again.
Oh, thank you so much, Clue. You have a wonderful evening and much more success to you, and I can't wait to see all the great things that are going to come from you.
No doubt. Thank you so much.
Okay, bye-bye. Brothers and sisters, give it up for Clue. We gonna finish this song on out. Brothers and sisters, I just wanted to finish out just a little bit of that song. That was Heavy D. I am so excited about my special guest, Clue, you know, calling in. The brother's busy. He's booked. He's doing his thing. And so I just want you to know that I support what you got going on, Clue. I really enjoy talking to you. You're very articulate. You're very intelligent. And your music is good. I can't wait to listen to more coming from you. Dallas, let's support Clue, you know, let's get the word out about what he's doing. Share the links, go to his page, support him, follow him. You know, just keep showing him the love that you know you're supposed to show to your brothers and your sisters. You understand what I'm saying to you? It's very important that we do that. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
This week on the Sister Speak Show, we've got you covered starting at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time on Tuesday with Coming to the Stage. Wednesday, The Search Effort. Thursday on the tour, my special guest, Charles Thomas, saxophonist for the City and Soul Creatures. Friday, get ready to laugh with The Laugh Line. Saturday, recording artist, Dallas, stand up, Clue, will be my special guest on the tour. And then Sunday on the platform, my special guest, author, creative writer, and speaker, Damon Alvarez, on the Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. Brothers and sisters, we want you to listen live and on demand to the Sister Speak Show. There are six segments dedicated to serving you, my brothers and sisters. We have The Platform, Coming to the Stage, The Culture Climate, The Laugh Line, The Tour, and The Search Effort. Oh, the Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, and evolve. The Search Effort, local, national, international attention to those who have gone missing in our communities. Cold cases in our communities, stories from survivors, special guest interviews. We want you to be on the Sister Speak Show. Are you a survivor of a stalking, a kidnapping? Do you have a missing loved one? Contact the Sister Speak Show at SGT, PGW, or at sistergoodthing.com. Airing January 2018, Wednesday, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time.
Brothers and sisters, welcome back to the tour on the Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action, a talk show for great minds that create, inspire, and evolve, my brothers and sisters. I have something I also want to share with you for those of you who listen to the Sister Speak Show on Amazon Alexa.
The Speak Show is even easier now with the new abilities available from Spreaker Skill on Amazon Alexa. With Spreaker on Alexa, you can now listen to the Sister Speak Show from even more places from all around the world. You also have navigation control, fast forward and rewind podcast to make sure you never miss a second of your favorite show. And then you can ask for show recommendations like the Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, and evolve.
Brothers and sisters, welcome back to the tour. So you heard it. Like now, if you're listening to the Sister Speak Show on Amazon Alexa, no matter what segment you're listening to, this is reaching even more countries internationally. And I'm so excited that the Sister Speak Show is a syndicated podcast. My brothers and sisters, it is quite an honor to have a syndicated podcast. So listen, if you're interested in being on the Sister Speak Show, we would love to have you on the Sister Speak Show. All you have to do is contact me through my direct message on Instagram at SGTPGW, or you can contact me at sistergoodthing.com. Go to the contact page, and all you have to do is inquire. Now, this is Riding High by recording artist Clue.
Yeah, old school flow, your game cut though. Bitch, the made a gator, watch a finger, you can't touch toe. Who ain't that year? You already know. Rain full of game, throw flame when I flow. Rock out the frame, won't change when I Chevy gold paint, flame going to the dope. I know the hating, man, do it on the low. While I'm riding high, spray the sky bank. AC on my windows, up and dank. Ash in my cup, I'm too cold to think. Going 2 miles per hour to the floor behind me, wait. Sitting so low that it's break my place. Put my bass so on that it shake my frame. Need to cut it down cause it shake my face. But I got it bitch beating so hard it caught a cape. Dying at the stendo, gone now, hear my sign up and glue on screw, and you know it's chop, right? I could probably start a party at a stoplight. Creeping slow, real flow, clean, candy bright, sees like a dream. Sun go down tonight, hit my beam. Posted up and let them flock the scene. Parking lot is where I reign as king, and if you're from the side, then you know what I mean. The dozer's up, so they gon' count the team. The chain glistening, clean as Krispy Kreme. Jam all the way through to the CD stock release date next year. When you see me cop, press button, fold up and remove my top. With my face on swollen, my trunk on knock. It's that summertime, ride high, waiting while I'm riding by. Sitting high like I'm trying to fly, swinging hard like I'm trying to die. Hey, they hate, hey, trash to me, my but hey, we made, so this shit on me, my this that summertime, ride high, waiting while I'm riding by. Sitting high like I'm trying to fly, swinging hard like I'm trying to die. Swinging through on the boulevard, I like to bring to you my whole pulling car. Now just sit back while me pull some bras. Like, excuse me, Miss Lady, know you're tired of walking. Go ahead, jump in, cause I'm tired of talking. Got a big back seat and it's mighty soft. If you got some panties on, gon' slide them. Put my left on the wheel, my right in your lap. You love half meal and you fur with that. Sit back and chill, we'll take time with that. But now hold my cup, cause it's time to snap. We showing up, rolling up, pulling up, chauffeured up. They know it's us. Golden touch, rim to match, kicks and hats, sick and fat, simplest back, pimpin's back, Cadillac. What I roll on them goals, triple folks with the spokes, walls right, fall right, all night, all right, y'all right. He need to stop drinking like this, so let me stop drinking right quick. Just enough time me to find my pick. Check their pocket, can't find my shoe. Somebody let us get a light right quick. Stop at the light, can't find my shoe. Hold it, control it, blow it out slowly. This shit that's stupid, at least that's what they told me. And I got enough to share with the homies and brought ladies too. So these told me this just what we do. From night to the morning with ladies, they say them datings make them cool. It's summertime, ride high, waiting while I'm riding by. Sitting high like I'm trying to fly, swinging hard like I'm trying to die. Hey, they hate, hey, trash on me, my but hey, we made, so this shit on me, my just that summertime. Swinging hard like I'm trying to die. They hate, trash on me, my.
They hating. Why they always hating? Brothers and sisters, you were listening to Riding High by Clue. You are on the tour. This is the Sister Speak Show on the tour. I am your host, Ayana, and I hope you've been having a wonderful, wonderful evening so far, my brothers and sisters. I am so excited about everything that is taking place with the Sister Speak Show. I'm so excited about my special guests. I'm so excited about you, my listening audience. I've had a wonderful, wonderful evening. So anyway, we're going to close this out. Tomorrow, my special guest on the platform will be Damon Alvarez. He is an author as well as a creative artist. I'm so excited about what he's going to be bringing to the Sister Speak Show on the platform. Don't forget, the platform coming to the stage, the culture climate, the search effort, the tour, and the laugh line, my brothers and sisters. Six segments dedicated towards you. We are the flavor in your ear on the Sister Speak Show. Spiritual inspiration shared through the arts, spiritual inspiration shared through Ayana. The Sister Speak Show, where contemporary meets vision, sound, and action. A talk show for great minds that create, inspire, and evolve. Don't forget that the Sister Speak Show is a talk show that will keep your mind and your soul informed, energized, and encouraged. We are a cultural renaissance platform that influences a climate that is conducive to who you are and who you should be. No reckless entertainment, just responsible listening nourishment. We don't go dumb. We go wisdom. On the Sister Speak Show, I'm Ayana. I hope you are having a wonderful evening. Be safe, be wise, and be full of joy. Be prosperous. be better than you were just a second ago. Anyway, my brothers and sisters, you have a wonderful evening. Take care.